Australopithecus garhi. This species is not well documented as it is defined on the basis of one fossil cranium and four other skull fragments, although a partial skeleton found nearby from about the same layer is usually included as part of the Australopithecus garhi sample. But every species, well documented or not, deserves a video, right? So here we are. Although similar to other Australopithecines, it displayed some surprising features. Individuals had long ape arms, small brain of about 450 cubic centimeters, robust cranial, facial and dental characteristics, and human-like longer legs, which suggests a change toward longer strides during bipedal walking. The fossils are significant as they help fill the period between 2 and 3 million years ago, a time with a poor human fossil record. Australopithecus garhi was a part of that age living in Africa from 2.4 to 2.6 million years ago. However, this is a date for the fossils only, not a date range for the species. More fossils need to be found in order for a species time range to be determined. Fossils of this species were mainly found from eastern Africa at the site of Bori, Middle Awash, Ethiopia. Australopithecus garhi were also thought to be more terrestrial. Specimens of this species were first discovered in 1990 and again later in 1996 when researchers recovered portions of the frontal and parietal bones as well as a maxilla that contained teeth from the Bori site in Middle Awash region of the Afar Depression in Ethiopia. The team named the new species Australopithecus garhi. The word garhi means surprise in the Afar language. This name was chosen because the scientists who discovered the skull were surprised by some of the features of the skull, in particular the enormous back teeth. More fossils are needed before it is possible to determine where this species fits on a family tree. The fossils showed some similarity to Australopithecus afarensis, which suggests it evolved from this species. Researchers say it may be a direct ancestor of modern humans, representing an evolutionary link between the Australopithecus and Homo, or it may belong on a side branch. But there are some scientists that claim that the large molar teeth show that Australopithecus garhi is related to Paranthropus aethiopicus. Fossils of Australopithecus garhi are associated with some of the oldest known stone tools along with animal bones that were cut and broken open with stone tools. If the antelope bones found at the site were broken by this species, then it is possible that this species was among the first to make the transition to stone tool making and to eating meat and bone marrow from large animals. Well, that is all that we have for you on this species, guys. Hope you liked the video. Thanks for watching, and for more videos like these, do check our channel out and please do not forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Till then, this is Halabella and see you soon in our next video.